A car out of one. I pray this devil died and get every evil thing the Lord got to give. And listen, I know you look at us in the state we in right now. Come your child.
Come
your child.
Come your child.
I know you look at us in the state we in right now. Black people on drugs and we suffering and dying. And I know it seems like you can do whatever you want to this people. I know it seems like this, but the time for glorifying yourself is soon at an end.
Send his prophets out on the streets to warn blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indian that the white man is the devil the Bible speaks of. He is the devil the Bible speaks of. He got America. Go enjoy America. Enjoy it. Let us help black people. We are full of pain. We are full of pain. You go help white people, man. You talking about you went across in Iraq to help for us to speak for us for our freedom. You don't know white men went across in Iraq to fight for no black man freedom. We are still in slavery. Don't tell me you went and fight for us. You went and fight for white America. Black people are dying in America. Don't tell me you went and fight for us.
The white man, the real devil.
The white man is the devil the Bible speaks of. And every nation on the earth is fed up of your bully ways. And they are going to fight back. But you know the good thing about blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indian, we got a God that's alive. We got a God that can send hurricanes, earthquakes, tornadoes. And we got a God that can send a white man into ISIS to fight. We got a God that will make the white man fight against the white man. Russia and America is going to fight against each other, and God is doing it. You know why? To free blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians from the grasp of this devil. He got America. Go enjoy America, man. You built Disney World. Go enjoy America. Enjoy the Caribbean, man. Go on your cruises.
There you go.
Go enjoy it. Let us stay here and tell black people how to get off drugs. How to get off crack cocaine. That's a problem in the black community, man. Teach our people to love each other, man. There's more than enough black on black crime. We out here teaching black people how to love black people, and white people can't see it. Because they are heartless. They are monsters. And they have not paid for their crimes. And the only reason why you are vets is because you are a criminal on the earth. If you were not a criminal, then you would not be vexed with what we are saying. You would not be angry with what we are saying. You will not be angry, you will agree with us. But because we come out here and tell white people the truth, they're angry. They're angry. They're angry. But this is the truth here. Give me Revelation 13 and 9. Give me Revelation 13 and 9. I'm going to bring it out, man. Let God word speak, man. Enough of all this garbage. Black people are dying in the street. Michael Brown died in the streets. He ain't going to be the last brother dying if we keep on loving white America.
That's right.
And I ain't telling you to go kill no white man. I'll be wrong. According to the Bible, God does not want us to pick up guns and go fight no white man. You know what God wants us to do? God wants us to look that man in the mirror and tell that man in the mirror, I'm going to sacrifice my life for my brothers and my sisters, my Hispanic brothers, my Hispanic sisters. We are all going to sacrifice our life and obey God. Let's obey God for once and stop all these foolish thoughts in our mind, our opinion about God love everybody. That ain't in the Bible.
That's right, brother.
It was never in the Bible. If God love everybody, let's get Revelation 13 and 9.
That's
read it.
Revelation chapter 13, verse 9. If any man have an ear.
Everyone out here have an ear. So it ain't speaking about that. It's speaking about if you can understand what's going to be brought out here right now, then you understand it good. Then you will understand in the last day that we are in the last days. Read.
If any man have an ear, let him hear. He that leadeth into captivity.
Now hold on. Don't read it too fast, man. A lot of these Christians have never been to this scripture in church. Never. They never read this before. So read it slow for them.
He that leadeth into captivity.
Yes. There was a man. There was a nation that led another nation into what?
Captivity.
Into captivity. The white race led good black people and bad black people into slavery. That's why good white people and bad white people got to go into slavery.
That's right.
It's only right. So ain't no white man can come up here and say he good. God don't want to hear that. Because when you brought our brothers, my foremother and my forefathers across here, you didn't care if he was good or bad. You wanted to build an empire. And you built it on racism, hatred. Now I come out here teaching love, and you say I'm preaching hate. I'm teaching black people, letting black people, giving black people comfort. I'm giving Hispanic people comfort.
Read the whole chapter. Now read the whole chapter.
Let's go read.
He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity.
He that what?
He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity.
What goes around comes around. What goes around comes around. You lead a nation into captivity. Then white man, you got to go into captivity. Good and bad. Good and bad. Let me show you in the Bible who you are, black man. Who you are, black man. Who you are on this earth. Are you an African-American? Are you Afro-American? Are you Muslim? Are you Christian? What are you, black man? Give me Jeremiah 14 and 2. Let me get into it. You go to church every day, but there's biblical names that blacks are called by, Hispanics are called by, and Native Indians are called by. When you look into the Bible, you ain't gonna see the Caucasian race. You ain't gonna see black people. You ain't gonna see Negroes. You ain't gonna see niggas.
That's right.
You ain't gonna see that. That's you know what you gonna see? Read this, Jeremiah 14 and 2.
Jeremiah chapter 14, verse 2. Judah mourneth.
What?
Judah mourneth.
Say Judah mourneth. Who is Judah? Judah is short for the Jews. Right?
Judah is southern Israel.
Judah, what?
Judah mourneth.
Judah mourneth.
Who captured?
Who is mourning on the earth right now? Who are mourning on the earth right now, black people?
Who captured northern
Hispanics
Israel?
And Native Indians.
Why was
and the
Judah
Jews are what?
Mourning.
Judah mourneth. And the gates thereof languish.
And the gates thereof languish. There is no one to get justice for us. When they say the gates thereof languish. When they say the gates thereof languish, it means that we got no leadership in America here. Black people ain't got no leadership in America here. Otherwise, we will know how to raise a family. We will know how to treat our sons and daughters. We will know how to do it. But we got no leadership in America, man.
They do not know what they're talking about.
Eddie Long is supposed to be a leader. And he is raising young boys in church. He's supposed to be a leader. But he is raping young boys in church.
That's right.
You understand? No, read on.
Babylon took over northern Israel.
They are black.
Babylon what?
Took over. They are black.
The Jews are what?
The they are black.
The Jews are what?
They are black.
The Jews are black.
And right.
The Jews are black.
That's right.
The real Jews are black. Those so-called Jewish people across there in Israel are liars. and culture bandits.
That's
they
right.
are not the Jews.
Right.
They are the Khazarian babies.
That's right.
Ashkenaz.
That's right.
Those are not God's chosen people. And in the near future, you will see it. In the near future, you will see if God is with the white man or with blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. You are going to see it, black man. You don't have to listen to me today, but one day you will listen, either in ash or with your flesh on your body. You're going to listen. You're going to understand what I'm saying one day. One day you're going to understand it. When you're 2 minutes away from that prison, you're going to know what you're going to say. You know what? I should have listened to those brothers.
Right.
When you're 2 feet away from that grave, you're going to say, I should have listened to that brother.
They're going
to be too late. No, read on. They are black unto the ground.
They are what?
Black unto the ground. Different shades of black. We know that, right?
That's
we come
right,
in different
black.
Shades.
That's right.
Got that dark color black.
That's right, black.
Get a nice caramel color. We got all colors, man.
Right.
Black unto the ground.
Right.
Now let's see who the fake Jews are. Come into Revelation 2:9.
Right.
Come into Revelation 2:9. Just show you that the Jews are black. This Bible is real.
That's
right. So real, it's so real, it prophesies the future, man. You understand?
What is Revelation?
Let's go. Revelation 2:9.
What is Revelation?
Revelation chapter 2, verse 9. I know thy works.
I what?
I know thy works.
He know black people and Hispanics and Native Indian work. He know how much jobs we gotta commit to just to survive in this place. He know our work, man. Read on.
And tribulation.
And he know our oppression in this place, man. Black people are oppressed, man. Mentally oppressed in this place. That's why we don't even know when someone loves us and when someone hates us.
That's right.
We don't even know it because we are mentally destroyed. We are oppressed in this place. Black brothers come out on the street and say black people are the best and we are hated. We come out and say Hispanics are the best and we are hated. We come out and say the Native Indians are the best and we are hated. We are hated in this place for teaching black people true love.
That's
for teaching black people, don't kill a brother if he steps on his shoes, man.
He's
worth more than that pair of shoes, that Nike shoes, man.
We
kill each other for a pair of Jordans. For a pair of Jordans. We are oppressed. And God knows our oppression, man. Read on.
And poverty.
And what?
Poverty.
And what?
Poverty.
We are poor in this place. That's why we gotta beg for food from the government. We are poor in this place, man. And Detroit, what happened? They couldn't pay for their water and the white man didn't want to lock it off. He left all the water off from those Detroit people, man. From black people. Why? Because we are poor in this place. Read on.
But thou art rich.
But what?
But thou art rich.
What makes blacks and Hispanic people and Native Indian people rich? You know what makes us rich? Because we are God's chosen people. We are the strongest on the earth. We run the fastest. We jump the highest. We are the best at everything on the earth. The black woman can cook her tail off. The Hispanic woman can cook her tail off. A Native Indian woman can cook her tail off. We are the best on the earth, man. We are the poorest, and we dress the flyest. Understand that, black man. We dress the flyest. Why? It ain't my coincidence, man, that the fastest man on the earth is a black man. It ain't by coincidence that the best basketball player is a black man.
There you go.
It ain't by coincidence the best man on the football field is a black man.
Tell the truth,
black man. Ain't by coincidence, black
not
man.
Baseball.
Ain't by it. Ain't it? Ain't. You understand?
Golf.
Those Hispanics. Golf. Tiger was black.
That's
right. Golf. Baseball. Name all the sports. Black people are the best.
That's right.
We are the best at everything.
That's right.
Read.
And I know the blasphemy.
He knows what?
The blasphemy. Uh-huh.
The what?
The blasphemy.
The lies. Listen to this lie. Read on.
Of them.
Of who?
Of them.
No, them. Speaking of a people. Read on.
Of them which say they are Jews.
Hold on, man. You sure you're reading that in that book there, man? Of them which say they are what?
They are Jews.
Who call themselves Jews?
Tell it to
the so-called Jewish man in Israel. Woo. But the Bible is saying what?
Synagogue.
I know the blasphemy of them who say they are Jews.
The white man is a liar. He is the devil on earth. He has deceived us into thinking we were not God's chosen people. But we are God's chosen people according to the Bible. Ain't my words. I never said that the so-called Jewish man lied. God said it in this Bible. It's in my words. I'm reading what's in this book. It's saying that a so-called Jewish man is a liar.
That's right.
Is a liar according to this Bible.
And a murderer.
The Jews are black unto the ground.
That's right.
And we can never change. No matter how much you kill us, you want to kill the Hispanics, you want to kill the blacks, the Native Indians, God is going to be with us. Can we agree? Christ was from the tribe of Judah, which makes him a Jew. Let's get a color of Christ. Revelation 1, let's get it straight to it. Revelation 1 and 13. Let's go straight to it, man. Because this ain't being brought out in the Christian church. This ain't being brought out across the earth. Read.
Revelations. Chapter 1, verse 13. Uh-huh. And in the midst of the seven candlesticks, one like unto the Son of Man.
It's Christ is speaking about here. That was in the midst of those seven candlesticks that represent the churches that was set up. Read.
Clothed with a garment down to the foot.
He had a garment like this on, down to the foot. Read on.
And girt about the paps with a golden girdle.
Now this is come on, man. This man had on a golden belt, war belt like this around his waist. Now you're going to see who dresses fly like this. Read on.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
His head and his hair were what?
White like wool.
White is a what? Color. Wool is a what? A texture. Who got white woolly here? Who got woolly here? That's right, sis. Who got woolly here? They say, Christ had white woolly hair. Now let's get the color, if that ain't enough. Read.
As white as snow, and his eyes were as a flame of fire.
And his eyes was a flame of fire. Meaning Christ drank some wine on this earth, man. He drank some wine, just like every black man in America. You drink some wine, man, your eyes are gonna turn red. Christ drank some wine, let's get more.
And his feet, like unto fine bread.
You sure you're reading that, man? Why am I seeing a picture of a white boy? Why am I seeing a picture of a white boy being Christ? Read it again.
And his feet like unto fine bread.
When nowadays I work hard on the job, still I come cross y'all. Still like I'm a criminal. My manhood. They like.